Welcome. Thanks for coming out on a beautiful day to hear Zigzag Quartet, one of our favorite groups. I can see the anticipation has been building. They weren't here last year. Now we have a lot of people here today, and for good reason. These folks have been performing extensively in New York and in Europe and all around the place. And last night they performed at the Montauk Library. We'd like to thank the Friends of the Library, which is primarily you, for your Friends memberships and for your contributions to our book sale. That is a huge help to this library, and it funds all of these concerts. So thank you for that. We had a computer malfunction, so we couldn't print out flyers for upcoming events. We have a few out there. We do have several of these, and I'll fight over the remaining. This is our little fall schedule, so do join us for the rest of our fall concerts if you're able to. Right now, we'll get started, so please welcome the Zigzag Quartet.
Thank you. great summer, and as you can see, today is really representative of fall coming our way, hopefully. We're a Zigzag Quartet. We've been here quite a few years, and we enjoy always returning back to the Hamptons, and we also play at Montauk as well at the library there. We just played there last night. And so this first tune that you heard, part of the set, is a Brazilian suite written by Ramadas Nathalie, and he's sort of the pioneer of bossa nova before it became bossa nova. And they brought all these styles of Brazil, which is completely different from one region to the next. The choro literally means to cry or lament. But the way you just heard it, it sounds like a happy, rhythmic, virtuosic kind of piece. So you can't be too sad for too long, I guess, in Brazil. The second piece is called Poada, and it means just song, melody. And the last one is Invocation of Jango. Jango was a god that was a tradition passed on from African slaves who were brought to Brazil, in the northern part of Brazil, and they preserved this tradition through rituals of drumming, dancing, chanting, and singing. So that tune you'll hear has a bit of a mystique to it. And these were all arranged by Laurinda Almeida, great Brazilian jazz guitarist. Thank you. 3.
Choose different ensembles or soloists every year to write pieces for, and a couple of years ago they chose us as the ensemble, and we had 5 pieces written for us, and we had 3 women composers and 2 men composers, and one of the composers is represented today, David Sampidis. He wrote a suite then for us, which is a Latin suite, and then subsequently we asked him to write another one, and these are 2 movements, and this is more of an American suite. And we're going to play today a blues and a calypso by David Sampidis.
Thank you.
stage back to South America again, to Argentina, where they're known for what kind of dance?
Tango.
Tango, right, sure. The old style Carlos Gardel type of tangos. Astor Piazzolla was sort of the creator of the new style of tango, Tango Nuevo, and spent many decades trying to find this style. He actually, as a teenager, though he was born in Argentina, lived in New York City as a teenager for about 10 years. And in the 1920s, when he was here, he heard people probably like George Gershwin, Duke Ellington, Cab Calloway, and all the jazz, American jazz greats, and was very much influenced by that. And so you'll hear in his music the fusion of jazz, classical, and tango. This piece is dedicated to his father, who passed while he was in New York City, struggling to become a successful composer. And his father passed away in Argentina. He wasn't able to go back and sort of pay his last respects and have his final words with him. So he wrote this piece as sort of a homage or homage to him. And Nonino in Italian means grandfather, right? And his Astor Piazzolla's son used to call Astor's father Nonino. So this is called Adios Nonino. And we hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
The next piece is a piece by, again, from the Music Under Construction Consortium of Composers, and this is Carolyn Lord, and she is based in New York City, and she wrote this piece, which is called, well, it's not called, the first movement is called 3, the second movement is called 4. So 3-4. I guess you could call it 7, right?
Thank you.
complaint, a few more concerts. Next Friday will be in, this coming Friday in Belport Library, where it's part of the Hispanic Heritage Month. And then on the 21st, we'll be at Peel at Woodmere Library in the beautiful Gold Hall over there. And we're performing a Latin program with Latin ballroom dancers, whom we've worked with in the past, and a flamenco dancer as well. So if you happen to be in the neighborhood or know somebody there, you know, please feel free to leave your email and we'll send you a mailer and let you know. And come say hello afterwards after the concert. This next piece, speaking of that concert with the dancers, I was asked to come up with something, an arrangement that's something Latin influenced, but an American with an American sense. And of course, Leonard Bernstein. I have trouble always saying Leonard Bernstein. So, has wrote the West Side Story, which was kind of based with about Latin Americans or Puerto Ricans in New York City, and this love story, Romeo and Juliet love story going on too. And so I arranged this particular tune, America, for our quartet. And let me know how it sounds, and be kind.
By the way, we also have some CDs for sale if anyone would like to take us home with you afterwards.
That was a good segue.
Thank you.
I'd like to introduce the band, Alexander Wu on piano. William Green on bass. Rex Benincasa on percussion. And I'm Francisco Roldan, and we are Zigzag. So the next piece is by the I think he's Uruguayan or Argentinian? Argentinian composer Daniel Benelli. He's living, living composer. And a few, like maybe 2 or 3 years ago, I went to a concert where he was at, and he had written a sextet for string quartet and dual guitars. And I really loved the piece, so I went up to him afterwards and said, "Would you like to do a piece for Zigzag?" And he said, "I would love to." So this is what he came up with. This is Preludio y Candombe. Candombe is a folk dance from the outskirts of Argentina, not from the city, but it's more from the country. So this is a prelude and candombe, and it's called Llamada de Tambores, or the call of the drums. That's a subtitle. Thank you.
book.
Of hearing him on his one of his last concerts at age 91. And he went out with his quartet and he sat on, it took him a while to get on stage, but then when he sat down, it was as though he was a 20-year-old again. He played a two-hour concert and it was just amazing. At that age, how much you still can grow as a musician. and he loved it. And anyways, this piece is a very historical piece, one of his more popular tunes. He was inspired on a trip to Istanbul. He was going to the Middle East, and this was sponsored by the U.S. State Department, and this was to create sort of peace and harmony in the late 50s. There was a lot of anti-American sentiments, and he was amongst many musicians who would go overseas, bring jazz or other types of American popular music to other countries and exchange, learn about their culture, their music, their art. And heard these musicians in the old town of Istanbul, and it was this interesting rhythm that I would like Rex to demonstrate quickly.
Oh yeah, this rhythm, it's in a time signature, it's in nine, it's a 9/8 time signature, and that means each bar of music has got nine small pulses in it, and it's divided up into two beats, and three beats, and that makes up your nine. So I'll play it slowly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So every time I hit the doom sound on the frame drum, I want you to clap. Get your hands up, ready?
You know you have the persistence.
We're gonna need you to clap one. 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now this rhythm is called an ashlama, sometimes called a karsalama, and this is a very standard folk rhythm throughout Turkey and Armenia, and belly dancers use it all the time. It's one of their big rousing dance numbers. Whenever they get done doing a belly dance show, then they take a tour around the room saying, look at my sparkly costume, aren't I beautiful? Here's my thing, Jim. And they dance off to this rhythm.
2 and called the blue rondo a la Turk. And the rondo is a very typical traditional classical form, rondo being a round, that you will hear this rhythm throughout, over and over throughout the whole piece. So, blue rondo a la Turk.